I hope you had a great DEF CON last day now. Great conversations, really great event. I want to talk about Ethereum, opportunities and obstacles on the Android platform. Not Android, the robot, Android, the operating system, mainly for mobile. First thing is quite obvious, like there are now a lot of Android devices out there. These are basically the sales curves of Android, and you see it's just rising, and the rest, which is not open platforms, is basically fading out. Symbian, yeah, gone soon. Other platforms, gone soon. Also, what is very important for me, the growth is mainly because you can get Android very cheaply on the emerging world, basically. So it's very distributed, Africa, South America, India, which is close to my heart. And because there are now a lot of devices out there, you can use them also for different stuff. You can use that, for example, to make offline transactions. There are some projects doing that. The Parity Assigner is the most used one currently. There's even a project, AirGap, that is completely focusing on that use case. And with Wallyth, I also support that flow. What you basically do, you use QR codes to build an AirGap between your key and your computer, for example, because you don't want to expose your key. Very nice in the discussion before, where do you store your keys? There's a project that goes in a similar direction, but without the air gap, basically, to connect the desktop wallet to a mobile wallet, where the mobile wallet has the key and the desktop wallet just does the UX and the depth displaying. It's Wallet Connect. Highly recommend you look into that. And later on, that will also work for mobile to mobile. Currently, it's desktop to mobile, but later on, we also can do that for natives, for native apps to make mobile to mobile. Another really cool thing you can do with Android is, for example, to use a Trezor via OTG. You use, if you have value that you want to protect, you should really use a hardware wallet. Also, these offline wallets that, like offline possibilities I described before, are not like a hardware wallet. A hardware wallet is much more, basically. It protects your key much more. And with Android, you have the possibility to use USB OTG on the go. You cannot, unfortunately, use that with iOS, but it really protects your keys very nicely. And with the latest generation of the Trezor, you even have USB-C, so it's really easy to plug it in, basically. Before, it was a bit a hassle with this OTG adapter, but now, just USB-C device, you always plug it in the right direction. Another thing that I'm really excited about now, and nice to see the team behind the Status Hardware Wallet also here, is the Status Hardware Wallet. Just seen that now in the Crypto Life Hackathon from Status, that happened just before, and the team gave a workshop there, and I'm currently implementing that in Wallyth, the support for that. They are really cheap. So in volume, you can get them for a euro, but in real volume. So now, low volume, like 5 euros, but they are really cheap. The problem is they don't have a display, but they can still fulfill a lot of really, really nice use cases. For example, imagine who of you has used an Ether card before? But so you had to enter basically all these words, which is kind of a nuisance. It was nice for the time, but we can use them and just tap them on your phone and you're finished. So you can really easily onboard users with Ether. And then you still have a hardware wallet. It's a full computer. So the key is on that computer. It's not, in the current flow, it's exposed for a backup. But for the signing flow, this one is not exposed. So you have a full hardware wallet for a real and not a hardware wallet without a display, but for a very, very low price. Also, that's unfortunately not possible on iOS. You can use NFC on iOS, but you cannot use this custom APD use. So you cannot use that there. Another point for to use Android. There's also one thing, it's Android protected confirmation, because now it comes to what are you displaying, basically. That's quite a new thing. You see 19th of October this year. They were talking about it, and until it's rolled out, it will take some time. But the big problem is you don't really trust your S that much. For example, it could hide certain information about what you're signing, and you don't really want to do that. So basically, trusted confirmation, you have a confirmation apart from the main operating system, basically. And I also want to use it for bank transfer, but we should use it to transfer DAI to some ENS address. And then you also don't go through the touchscreen. You go basically through the confirmation buttons to really have as least attack surface as possible. Yeah. Android is not only mobile. Android is also Android Things, IoT. We heard IoT is a really, really big topic right now. You can now also deploy Android apps on Chromebooks. You don't get the full features from the Android operating system there, but you can reuse the apps you are writing. So people that know me, there's no talk without me mentioning Kotlin. Kotlin is a really nice operating language. You can write Android apps in there. And at the last KotlinConf keynote, they were mentioning there's now 1 in 4 apps out of the top 1,000 apps uses Kotlin. And Kotlin is not that old, but it's a really, really beautiful language. And also there was recently the Octoverse, that's basically from GitHub census, and now Kotlin is the fastest growing language on GitHub. And as I like dry code, I didn't want all this code in Wolith. So I extracted a library that you can also all use. It's called Ketherium, Kotlin Ethereum. Currently, it's mainly targeted for wallet development, key holding, signing, ERP-155, ERC-55, and so on. But in the future, I want also to extend that to dApps. Now let's talk about decentralization. Really like that it was topic of the discussion before. One big thing is like most mobile wallets currently rely on central services like Infura or Etherscan. Unfortunately, I also removed the Lite client from, or I moved it to a special flavor from Wolith because the user experience wasn't yet that nice. The problem is the Lite client is working, but there's no incentive layer yet, so and people need to run full nodes. Running full nodes is expensive, so not many people are doing that. But just at DEF CON this year, Slockit presented the Incubed client, and I'm really excited about that. It's a minimal verification client, so you verify. It has an incentive layer, basically, and you don't need to participate in the peer-to-peer chatter. They basically did it for IoT, but the same problems they had on IoT, we have on mobile. Limited bandwidth, limited resource power, computation power, and so on. So we can use that looking forward. They released it 2 days before DEF CON, and I really had to, don't look into that now, attend DEF CON. But after DEF CON, I really want to dig in, and I really hope fast to support that. Also, distribution comes with a lot of centralization. Most get their apps now from Google Play. So that's a problem. Like, that's Google controls, and that's often what people say. Yeah, on Android, you have the same problems. Like, it's centralized, you rely on Google. I say, you don't rely on Google. Because it's an open source project, you can fork it, Android, but the store is a big problem. Fortunately, there are alternatives already. There is, for example, FDroid, which is an open source store, so only open source apps can be hosted there, and they checked that, and not only does the app is open source, but all libraries downstream are also Libre software. But you should go even further, like I'm envisioning a store, basically, which is completely decentralized with reproducible builds where we don't rely, because it's also a central party. That's a bit the problem there. But it's already a bit better than Google Play. Unfortunately, like these are all the results for Ethereum on FDroid currently. That's unfortunately not that much. So we should really, really push there to get more dApps and wallets to be on the store. So go to your wallets, push them and say, go to FDroid and release your apps there. I want to talk about subtraction a little bit because Aya was mentioning it now a lot and I thought a lot about that. And also for Wolith, like I don't want a browser in there. You should, like in Unix, there's this thing, do one thing right. And I only want that to be basically a storage for keys, managing for keys, and then other apps should interact with that. Now we're doing a test balloon with PeepDroid, that's basically a PeepRep client to try out this concept. So I think the wallet should just do the wallet stuff, and then native dApps are communicating with that. We talked a lot bit about that at the Ethereum Magicians, which was just happening before DEF CON, which was really nice, all dApp developers coming together and talking to each other, and really great. you find the notes on ethereummagicians.org. And yeah, thank you very much for listening. This is follow-up. This is a site where you can reach me. This is the Wall ETH project. Have a wonderful rest of DEF CON. Thank you very much.